Coming up next on the Jeff Crilley Show, it's been a year since lockdown. We're going to talk to a couple of trailblazing young ladies who didn't let that stop them. That's next.
Many are predicting that the worst is yet to come, which is unfortunate, said one person here. Until now, they've enjoyed the reputation of being the nation's icebox.
Watched a burglar in his home this morning by webcam.
As a journalist of over 25 years, stories are what make my world turn.
Reporting live from the Dallas newsroom tonight, Jeff Crilley, Fox 4 News.
But in 2008, I took the jump from my familiar life and started a PR firm from my home.
We're talking about anyone with a camcorder like the one I'm using becomes a television network.
We started slowly growing the company, and we now have over 100 clients, and we've branched into the world of live digital broadcasting. I now own 8 different TV studios and have a huge team, and the stories that I now get to share are sometimes the most important of my life. Life has a funny way of coming around full circle. This is the Jeff Crilley Show.
Well, they say there's 3 kinds of people, the kind of people who watch things happen, the kind of things, people who make things happen, and the kind of people who look and say, what just happened? With me today in studio, a couple of young ladies who absolutely make things happen, Stacey Schieffelin and Debbie Saviano from Women's Leadership Live.
Thank you for coming on the show.
Oh my gosh, honored to be here.
Absolutely.
When we talk about making things happen, we just came off the pandemic. Hopefully society is opening up and we're all getting the vaccine and we're going to be okay. During this year of the pandemic, there was a lot of uncertainty. And I know you guys work with a lot of small business owners across the country. Mm-hmm. Some people can put their heads over, under the covers and suck their thumb and cry, and others can come out swinging. So Stacey, let's start with you. The entrepreneurs and people you're working with, they were not hibernating this last year.
No. I think Debbie and I can tell you, we were busier this year during the pandemic than we've had been in the last 8 years of running Women's Leadership Live, because it's all about empowering women and enlightened men and bringing them to a place where they want to be for their lives, their communities, and for their businesses. And we didn't stop. It was nonstop, like continual business building, relationship building, selling our products, as we're on 26 years on 8 networks around the globe in 28 countries. So even though I wasn't live going to Russia, to China, to Dubai, to Australia, all over Europe, Italy, Germany, France, Canada, I don't want to forget anybody, US, UK. UK, all our networks, we did everything live from our own studios. Right here. Love these studios you guys have built. Oh my gosh, they're so incredible. I mean, why would you want to do your show from your home?
You would
never. If you're out there doing a podcast today, or you're doing your business meetings and you don't have a great, it's almost, it's more than a studio here, don't you think? It's atmosphere. It's a philosophy. It's a culture. You walk in this place. It's like live, work, you want to stay. This is the place. Thank you so much for building something that people could still run their businesses day to day in. I love your studios, Jeff.
Don't stop.
Realness Communication Network. Either be here or be square, because if you're not here, it's not happening. We're just telling you. It's so beautiful. And then light makes us look really good, don't you think?
Yes, Stacey. Important. I never understood, but light is very important.
So, Debbie, before we get into kind of the deeper facets of things like LinkedIn and things that everybody should be doing, tell us more about Women's Leadership Live and why somebody would want to be a part of this.
Well, what happened to us is we started with events with Linda, our other co-founder, Linda McMahon, and we moved in when she went to the White House. We joked she got a better gig. So when she went to the White House,
2 years in the cabinet,
we kept going. We said, okay, what do we need to do to bring it all together? Well, retail, brick and mortar, HSN, online, every space you can have for your product, your service, or your event. And we took that and we made a plan for it. Little did we know COVID would hit. We were already prepared. We already had a strong online presence. We were already active out there. We understood the power of digital presence and how if you don't have that, you're not going to be a business. That's why this entire facility that you, I mean, this the whole
8 studios, incredible,
amazing that you have set up. People have to have a presence online. And so we were able to take our women from where they were with their product, their service, or their event, and continue serving them.
Yes.
And we did that because we had launched our cohort, Joe Packham, who has Where Women Create Work, and she has Cook and all these magazines. We were on a tour.
Yeah.
March was our beginning of our tour.
Oh, 2020.
And it was, 50 city tour with wrapped buses and huge, if I can say, thank you for the Irving Chamber of Commerce, City Group that's here in Dallas, in Irving. That we had huge 150 national sponsors.
Amazing.
And we were taking this magazine around the country about women working stronger together and how important that was.
Right.
Well, then COVID hit.
Right.
So what does Debbie think about?
One week,
like, okay, we got three events on our SMU.
We got Dallas in,
City Group,
and then Christus, Irving Chamber of Commerce, SMU.
Yep.
The networking groups. We did all
we
that.
We did five events in 3 days, and then COVID hit.
COVID hit,
Debbie
says,
well, what are we going to do? What are we going to do with a national tour that was supposed to be on the road? Debbie, you want to talk about how we worked with our ambassadors? That was incredible.
So we had 50 ambassadors across the country. We actually had over 100, but we had one, you know, in every state, in every part of the country. We took those women and we started sharing the information online, because you can't stop when you've done all this. All these women who were in this magazine, all these entrepreneurs across the country shared their story.
It's like incredible people.
Yeah, we wanted to keep going. So we had Zooms, and we had different activities to where we could go online. And we didn't have to just, I mean, obviously we preferred the other, because we'd spent months of preparation and planning. But
yeah, and you spend hundreds of thousands of dollars in a tour. It's not inexpensive to all overnight. And many businesses out there today understand they lost hundreds of thousands of dollars in a plan for second and third and fourth quarter that never came to fruition. Although, for the businesses that we know, they didn't stop. Our business at HSN and QVC, because we're now owned by QVC at Home Shopping, our business is up 44%.
Wow.
But think of how it affected everyone. Right. I mean, we're staying at home, we're shopping more, our whole family's involved. It doesn't matter what platform you were using to shop, you were doing it digitally.
Yes.
So our world changed from our brick and mortar relationships and in Barnes & Noble with our magazines and all of 250 stores across the country, national chains. We went digital. So we shared our magazine digital, even
Love
when
it.
People couldn't get out and get it.
That's called grit.
Right. And it's called having a plan B. Because you have to always ask yourself, and I use the example of Canva. Used to, when I did LinkedIn profiles and when we've done things for clients that we have, we would pay someone $500 to create a LinkedIn banner. Canva came up, and overnight those people didn't have a job, literally, because the technology was there. So you always have to ask yourself, if I can't do a tour, what do we do next?
What's the next plan B?
You better have a plan.
And we've been blessed that we think like that. Well, I think in live TV, you've been in it your whole life, Jeff.
Yeah.
You know what happens if cameras go down, sound goes out. Well, same with us on live television selling products to market. We still have to get product to market. Well, what do? You got to pick up and run. You just
don't
stop.
Well, let's talk about LinkedIn, because that's so important for small business owners. And I know you're very passionate about it. We're gonna use Stacey's LinkedIn as an example of something that I should be doing better, because you'll notice that Stacey and I are a second friend, right? Right?
And what's that mean, Debbie? Because I don't know. Jeff know.
There's a first connection. So Jeff and I are connected on LinkedIn. He's a second because you and I are connected. So that's what that means. First, second, third connections. And anyone?
So see, I never connected. See, I didn't connect with Jeff. So it was my fault, not you.
Well,
Jeff.
I don't know. Okay, so it says reaching out. So
hasn't sent an invite. Well, they'll take care of that this afternoon.
We certainly will, because Debbie will make sure of it.
Okay, so let's put Debbie's up.
Put Debbie up.
The thing to think about with a LinkedIn profile is when someone comes here, 78% of the people are only going to look at the banner, the picture, and the headline. And so you have to capture their attention immediately. And a lot of people say, well, I don't use LinkedIn. And I always have to remind them, it's not about them. If you do a Google search or a search on
DuckDuckGo,
the first three things will come up as LinkedIn. Whether it's good, bad, or indifferent, it's coming up.
Wow.
So you want to make sure your profile represents you as the professional you want people to know you as. That headline is critical, because if someone comes here, they know what we do. We design, we promote, we execute customized campaigns for products, services, and events. That's what we do. Everyone knows that. I'm not in the business of a taxidermy. What a silly analogy, but whatever. So they know what we do.
Right.
So it's important
to
answer those questions.
You tend to get a more savvy business audience on LinkedIn than you would on any other platform.
Yeah. It's true,
a professional mindset. People don't go there scrolling through just to find something in the feed like they do everything else.
Right.
And I always tell people, for 2021, the most valuable real estate in the world right now is the scroll. Because people are scrolling. No one leaves home without their phone.
Right.
We'll forget our purse before our phone.
The funny cat videos, you have to go to another platform.
Yes.
LinkedIn is about
video. We do that.
Let's talk about your app. We're going to put it up on the screen so people can get a glimpse of it. Tell us about Women's Leadership Live app.
We're so excited. Oh, my gosh.
This has been on Debbie's bucket list for, like, well, so 8 years at least.
The other day, David, we were all three together. We were working on this. And David said, this has been a dream of ours. And we can remember when we were talking about it in Florida, in the car, in the
where we were, what time it was, my
exactly,
husband.
Everything.
And we were talking about it.
We wanted this. So this is a community app. So if you think about the social media platforms today, you are on rented space. You don't own the land.
Sure.
So you don't own the land. You don't control anything. This app, we own. Everything is our community. We'll be able to run algorithms of who our people are. We'll have chats. We'll have channels. We are beyond excited about this app. It'll launch within the month.
That's awesome.
Within the month, so we'll have it out there, and we'll have a link from our website, which it was iconic back in the day. If you think about, and if you're like, I don't understand the app, just think about when we did WordPress to create a website. That's what app is today for us, because on our app, we can have Debbie's curriculum. She was a principal for over 30 years. She knows everything about education. So she wants to educate women on how to bring their product brand to market and the spirit of who they are to the world. So we can put curriculum on there. We can have our videos, our interview today.
We'll
put that on there. We can have a donation button that people can donate. They can buy my YBF Beauty products on there.
Yes.
There's so much thing. It's kind of like we're taking our TV, our social,
because
we'll have our Facebook, our Twitter, and everything run to our app. It's all in one location.
Brilliant.
And it makes it so easy for people to communicate and share.
Yes. Well, some people have organizations. You guys are leading a movement. And I've got a nice video. It's kind of an overview video. Let's go ahead and roll that now.
Women's Leadership Live. It's an organization about women, for women, by women, that want to empower and inspire and educate women to know that they can be the best they could possibly be every day.
Women entrepreneurs are better investments on Shark Tank than men.
Women do need to feel that they are part of a community. And when they are, they thrive. And they grow, and they're more successful. And we really want women to understand and to know that this greatness that they have within them is not something they have to aspire to be, but something that is automatically there.
Let's come together. Let's be the team that makes incredible things happen.
World that we live in today, you cannot say that you did everything alone.
Women who are seeking guidance, they want mentors, they want leadership, they want tools, techniques, strategies, what's worked, what hasn't worked, and they want to be around women who they know are going to champion them, support them, and give them the counsel to be the best they can be.
You have to be confident. Women's Leadership Live can take women to the next step.
The responsibility we have as women to support each other and also to bring along that next generation.
Well, one of the things I love is that it's an organization you lift as you climb, and you really support others, don't you?
Absolutely.
That's the premise, because we all can't, none of us can do anything alone. You know, Jeff, how you've built your empire here with your family and your team at the studios. I mean, none of us can do anything by ourselves. We need each other, and we need to help support, uplift, and really take each other to the next level. I mean, it's not about who gets there first. Let's get there together.
And one of the expressions I use is it's not the 50 people in the room or the 100 people in the room. It's the 50 people each one of them knows very well.
Absolutely.
So the connections that you make can really change the trajectory of your country, your company, right?
Yeah, absolutely. And our country.
Yes.
Think about how we can all come together and do so much to change everything we're in right now. We can be the spark of change we want to see.
And we are so fortunate. Stacey and I feel so blessed, so humbled to have so many women in our circle, if you will, who do support one another. And we made that clear from day one that you're only here if you want to do that. We don't want the tacky caddy. We don't want that attitude.
Yes.
There's no room for that in business.
Yeah,
so we're
that.
All in business to just help support one another, be the best we can be.
So we do that online. We do that any opportunity we can. we know who have certain expertise and skills and abilities to help others, we recommend those people.
That's right.
Always
share the knowledge.
So we've got about a minute left. So final thoughts. I mean, one of the expressions I love is you got to circulate to percolate. There's a lot of people in small business that, you know, they're introverts. They're sitting behind their computer hoping that everything will happen behind the computer. But you do have to get out and network,
sure.
Don't you?
Absolutely.
For sure. The beauty of social media, if you will, is for the introvert. That's who it was really created by. Mm-hmm. They're introverts, the people who did most of that. So they're able to do that. And we've done a lot of Zooms. We've done a lot of different things where they can be in their home and have that comfort, but get on a Zoom. We've done Facebook watch parties at 5 o'clock in the morning when we had West Rock Coffee and with HSN. Stacy's in Florida. I'm in Texas. We have women across the country doing a pajama party at 5 o'clock in the morning. So you show people, and when they know there's trust there, I think it makes a difference.
It's trust, which we talk about, you know,
absolutely.
That circle of influence of your people, and you trust one another, and you know each other's got each other's back. That's the important thing. But we're just so honored to come to your studios, and congratulations on all of your success.
You.
It's incredible what you've built. How long have you had the studios now?
So about 3 years.
Three years.
The last year has been meteoric.
I was going to say, from when we were here a year ago to now.
You've grown times three. The size of everything is huge.
You're very kind. You're very kind. We're gonna end by putting up the website so people can get in touch.
Women's connect on social media.
Oh yeah, womensleadershiplive.com, and make sure you connect with us on LinkedIn as well.
Absolutely.
Thing number one is you and I are connected. That's awesome. Well, thank you so much, ladies, and we'll have to have you back again soon.
Thank you.
God bless.
You bet. That's it for now. We'll see you next time.